In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Dear brethren, on this most sacred night, in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed over from death to life, the Church calls upon her sons and daughters, scattered throughout the world, to come together to watch and pray. If we keep the memorial of the Lord's Paschal Solemnity in this way, listening to his word and celebrating his mysteries, then we shall have the sure hope of sharing his triumph over death and living with him in God. Let us pray. O God, who through your Son bestowed upon the faithful the fire of your glory, sanctify this new fire, we pray, and grant that by these Paschal celebrations we may be so inflamed with heavenly desires that with minds made pure we may attain festivities of unending splendor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Christ yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, all times belong to him, and in all ages. To him be glory and power through every age, forever and ever. Amen. By his holy and glorious wounds, may Christ the Lord guard us and protect us.
Amen.
Amen. May the light of Christ rising in glory dispel the darkness of our hearts and minds. Light of Christ,
thanks be to God.
Light of Christ,
thanks be to God.
light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Exalt, let him exalt the hosts of heaven. Exalt, let angel ministers of God exalt. Let the trumpet of salvation sound. Aloud our mighty King's triumph. Be glad, let earth be glad as glory floods her. Ablaze with light from her eternal King. Let all corners of the earth be glad, knowing an end to gloom and darkness. Rejoice, let Mother Church also rejoice, arrayed with the lightning of his glory. Let this holy building shake with joy, filled with the mighty voices of his peoples. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just. With ardent love of mind and heart, and with devoted service of our voice, to acclaim our God invisible, the Almighty Father, and Jesus Christ our Lord, his Son, his only begotten, who for our sake paid Adam's debt to the eternal Father, and pouring out his own dear blood, wiped clean the record of our ancient sinfulness. These then are the feasts of Passover, in which is slain the Lamb, the one true Lamb, whose blood anoints the doorposts of believers. This is the night when once let our forebears, Israel's children, This is the night that with a pillar of fire banished the darkness of sin. This is the night that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace and joining them to His holy ones. This is the night when Christ broke the prison bars of death and rose victorious from the underworld. Oh, wonder of your humble care for us. Oh, love of charity beyond all telling. To ransom a slave, you gave away your son. Oh, truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ. Oh, happy fault that earned so great, so glorious a Redeemer. The sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, washes faults away, restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to mourners. Oh, truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth, and divine to the human. On this, your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of peace and of your servant's hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. Therefore, O Lord, we pray you that this candle, hallowed by the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. Receive it as a pleasing fragrance, and let it mingle with the lights of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets. Christ your Son, who coming back from death's domain has shed His peaceful light on humanity and lives and reigns forever and ever.
Thank you.
Dear brethren, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the word of God. Let us meditate on how God in times past saved his people, and in these last days has sent his Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete his paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption. I ask now that you please be seated and extinguish your candles.
Reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth, God said, "Let us make man in our image and after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all the wild animals and all the creatures that crawl on the ground." God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on the earth." God also said, "See, I give you every seed-bearing plant all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food. And to all the animals of the land, all the birds of the air, and all the living things that crawl on the ground, I give all the green plants for food." And so it happened. God looked at everything he had made, and he found it very good. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,
Please stand. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who are wonderful in the ordering of all your works, may those you have redeemed understand that there exists nothing more marvelous than the world's creation in the beginning, except that at the end of the ages, Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
You may be seated.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward, and you lift up your staff, and with hand outstretched over the sea, split the sea in two, that the Israelites may pass through it on dry land. But I will make the Egyptians so obstinate that they will go in after them. Then I will receive glory from Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and charioteers. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I receive glory through Pharaoh and his chariots and charioteers." The angel of God who had been leading Israel's camp now moved and went around behind them. The column of cloud also, leading the front, took up its place behind them, so that it came between the camp of the Egyptians and that of Israel. But the cloud now became dark, and thus the night passed without the rival camps coming any closer together all night long. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord swept the sea with a strong east wind throughout the night, and so it turned into dry land. When the water was thus divided, the Israelites marched into the midst of the sea on dry land, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. The Egyptians followed in pursuit. All Pharaoh's horses and charioteers went after them, right into the midst of the sea. In the night watch, just before dawn, the Lord cast through the column of the fiery cloud upon the Egyptian force a glance that threw it into a panic. And so he clogged their chariot wheels that they could hardly drive. With that, the Egyptians sounded the retreat before Israel, because the Lord was fighting for them against the Egyptians. Then the Lord told Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may flow back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and their charioteers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea flowed back to its normal depth. The Egyptians were fleeing head on toward the sea when the Lord hurled them into its midst. As the water flowed back, it covered the chariots and the charioteers of Pharaoh's whole army, which had followed the Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them escaped. But the Israelites had marched on dry land through the midst of the sea, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel on that day from the power of the Egyptians. When Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the seashore, and beheld the great power that the Lord had shown against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and believed in him and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. "I will sing to the Lord, for he is gloriously triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Please stand. Let us pray. O God, whose ancient wonders remain undimmed in splendor even in our day, for what you once bestowed on a single people, fleeing them from Pharaoh's persecution, by the power of your right hand, now you bring about as the salvation of the nations through the waters of rebirth. Grant, we pray, that the whole world may become children of Abraham and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without pain and without cost, drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread, your wages for what fails to satisfy? Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully. Listen, that you may have life. I will renew with you the everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David, as I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and a commander of nations. So shall you summon a nation you knew not, and nations that knew you not shall run to you because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, who has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his ways and the wicked man his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God, who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. For just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down, and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You are the Lord.
Please stand. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, sole hope of the world, who by the preaching of your prophets unveiled the mysteries of this present age, graciously increase the longing of your people, for only at the prompting of your grace do the faithful progress in any kind of virtue, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who make this most sacred night radiant with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church a spirit of adoption, so that renewed in body and mind, we may render you undivided service. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever. And please be seated.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ raised from the dead dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death,
He died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to Matthew. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven, approached, rolled back the stone, and sat upon it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. The guards were shaken with fear of him and became like dead men. Then the angel said to the women in reply, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are seeking Jesus, the crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples he has been raised from the dead. And he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you." Then they went away quickly from the tomb, fearful yet overjoyed, and ran to announce this to his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on their way and greeted them. They approached, embraced his feet, and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Good evening.
Good evening, Father.
May I begin by first wishing to you here present and to those who watch this Mass on video throughout the world a most blessed and joyous Easter. Happy Easter.
Thank you,
Father. Thank you all. In his farewell discourse on Holy Thursday night, Jesus announced his imminent death and resurrection to his disciples by stating, "I go away and I will come to you." This is from the 14th chapter of John's Gospel, verse 28. For you and I, dying is a going away. It is definite, there is no return until the resurrection on the last day. Jesus, on the other hand, says of his own death, "I go away and I will come to you." It is by going away that he is now able to come back. His going ushers in a completely new and greater way of being present. Please allow me an opportunity to explain this apparent irony. By his death, Jesus enters into the love of the Father. His death is an act of love. Love, unlike death, is immortal. It is by his returning to the immortal love of the Father, Jesus' going away is transformed. And that is why, if you remember, the gospel accounts say they don't recognize Jesus. It is a transformation that takes place. Now, this transformation is based upon the love of the Father, and it allows for his new coming. Now, his new coming ushers in his new presence. And it is his new presence with the members of the church, which does not come to an end. During his earthly life, Jesus, like all of us, was tied to the external conditions of bodily existence. He is, like we are, limited to one space at one time. He gets tired. He gets hungry. He has emotions. He is sad. He is joyful. Now, it is our material body which limits us. It's limited our earthly existence, both for us now and for Jesus when he was in the flesh. But due to his transformation through his salvific act of his passion, his death, and resurrection, Jesus' transformation now supersedes his bodily existence. That makes sense to you. He is able to now go through barriers. Think about it. He's able to appear to his disciples in the upper room as he comes through the locked doors. You have, in a sense, an ethereal presence that he can go through a material object, but yet he still has a physical presence because he looks at Thomas and says, "Touch me, see that I am not a ghost." Now, this presence of Jesus, not only is he able to go through exterior barriers, but more importantly, he's able to cross an interior barrier, the barrier that separates you from me, which allows us to express ourselves now as members of one body, his body, the church. That is why, whenever he gave us that great prayer, "Our Father," it is literally now fulfilled we as members of his body in unity are able to pray, "Our Father." And it is his risen presence exemplified in the most holy Eucharist that Christ is now present at all times in his church for his body. That's why we say Christ yesterday, Christ today, Christ forever. He is present at all times. Now, it is in the sacrament of baptism, which we would normally celebrate tonight if we had a person coming into the church who needed baptism, but our two candidates tonight have already been baptized. So we won't see that. But it is in baptism that the risen Lord enters into the door of your heart. And it is because of our baptism that we no longer stand alongside each other, and we don't stand in opposition to each other. The reality of baptism is that the risen Lord is present to you and to me. He comes to you and to me, to all people. And he joins his life with ours, and he draws each of us into that inner divine life with his heavenly Father. We become one, not only with him, but we become one with each other. Now, this may sound a little bit abstract. It may sound unrealistic, but for we, the baptized, we believers, this is real. And every day, as we live the Christian life to the best of our ability, we understand this reality, not just in mere words, but through our experience. We realize that believers are never separated. We are never cut off from God or each other. We may have people who watch this Mass on different continents, and they do. We may have people from different cultures, social structures, and realistically, years from now, we might have people in a distant historical time period. But we are all connected. We are all members of the one body of Christ. Christ is present to all of us, equally, undivided. Now, this is the foundation for us to build upon, that we are all, in essence, the same. We all have the same identity. It's an identity rooted in the risen Jesus. And in that, we are with him and with each other. It is our communion. And that is, if you remember, one of the four pillars of our faith. Catholic oneness. It is in that oneness, that communion, that fact that we are Catholic with a small c, universal, that we are able to say tonight, Catholics throughout this world in unison, Christ is risen today. Generations before us said that same thing on this night. And pray God, generations after us will say the same thing. May Almighty God be with you. May he bless you. The Father, the Son, the the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
O God, who by the invisible power accomplish a wondrous effect through sacramental signs, and who in many ways have prepared water, your creation, to show forth the grace of baptism. O God, whose Spirit in the first moments of the world's creation hovered over the waters, so that the very substance of water would even then take to itself the power to sanctify. O God, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed regeneration, so that from the mystery of one and the same element of water would come an end to vice and a new beginning of virtue. O God, who caused the children of Abraham to pass dry shod through the Red Sea, so that the chosen people, set free from slavery to Pharaoh, would prefigure the people of the baptized. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed with the Holy Spirit, and as he hung upon the cross, gave forth water from his side along with blood, and after his resurrection commanded his disciples, "Go forth, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." Look now, we pray, upon the face of your church, and graciously unseal for her the fountain of baptism. May this water receive by the Holy Spirit the grace of your only begotten Son, so that human nature, created in your image and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism and from the squalor of the life of old, may be found worthy to rise to the life of newborn children through water and the Holy Spirit. May the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, we pray, come down through your Son and to the fullness of this font, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Tonight we have the privilege of confirming one of our own. Rachel, would you please come forward with your sponsor? Rachel, the Lord receives you into the Catholic Church. His loving kindness has led you here, so that in the unity of the Holy Spirit, you may have full communion with us in the faith that you have professed in the presence of his family. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed your daughter from sin and gave her a new life. Send your Holy Spirit upon her to be her helper and guide. Give her the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill her with the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Catherine, be sealed with the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you, Catherine.
Would you please stand as your candles are being lit? And now we, as one family, will renew our baptismal promises with the response of I do. Dear brothers and sisters, through the paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. You may extinguish your candles. coming together as one family in faith, let us offer to God now our prayers, our needs, and our petitions.
That every member of God's holy church might be renewed in hope and faith through joy in the resurrection of our Lord, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in all the world and freedom and justice for all who are oppressed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the newly baptized members of the church here and throughout the world, as they begin their new life in Christ Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christians around the world separated by our histories, but rejoicing in our common baptism as we continue to proclaim Christ risen and seek true unity in our Lord, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community of faith renewed tonight in Christ's love, filled with the Holy Spirit, and sent on a mission of reconciliation to our neighbors near and far, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray for our brothers and sisters who are not able to be here for this Mass, and for those who watch this Mass on video, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us lastly pray for the repose of the soul of our Coptic brothers and sisters who lost their life on Palm Sunday due to the terrorist attack in Egypt. For them, this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Offering all our prayers to the Father, let us conclude with a prayer in honor of the Blessed Trinity. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the grace of the Lord in his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal mysteries may, by the working of your power, bring us to the healing of eternity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But on this night, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We broke when your death, O Lord.
offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
With the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but I will say the word, and my soul shall be
We'd now like to invite those who will receive their first communion to come forward. Rachel, would you please come forward? The body of Christ. Bailey, would you please come forward?
The blood of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this paschal sacrament one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin. Amen. And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exalting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen. Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is in. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Before you leave, just a reminder, we will be having a little reception for Rachel and Bailey, and it'll be in the Sullivan Center, so you're all invited to attend. Thank y'all. Our prayer to St. Michael.
Holy Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and to you, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the divine power, thrust into hell, Satan and all the other evil spirits, who wander through the world seeking to ruin the souls. Amen.
And the divine praises.
Blessed be God. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, your God and true name. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Consoler. Blessed be the Great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be our holy Immaculate Conception. Blessed be our glorious Assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be St. Joseph from his chaste house. Blessed be God, his angels, and his saints.